Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In the last video, we have seen how we can install MySQL and configure the MySQL on EC2 instance. So in this video, we will see how we can allow remote access to MySQL. By default, MySQL is only configured to listen for local connections. To access MySQL remotely, we have to change some configurations so that MySQL can be accessed from an external IP. To enable this, let's open the MySQL config file. So I have already connected to my EC2 instance. Go to /etc MySQL d config, enter. You can find MySQL d config file. Open up this file, sudo nano MySQL d config. So find this bind address and change this IP to 0.0.0.0. So this will allow the MySQL to connect from any IP. Save this file and exit. And restart the MySQL. Sudo service MySQL restart and this step is done. So this was the first step. So make sure your IP must be 0.0.0.0 in the config file. Second, we need a user who can connect from remote instead of localhost. So first, login into MySQL shell. Sudo MySQL user root So first fetch the list of users. As you can see, I have created a user code Sagar in the last video and its host is localhost. So we have to change this host so that we can connect from remote with this user. So to change the host, we can use command rename user. Rename user code Sagar. We have to use braces. Code Sagar at localhost 2 code Sagar at percentage. So I am using percentage, so this user can connect MySQL from any IP. If you have no users in your MySQL, then you can create one also. To create user, we can use statement create user. Code remote at percentage identified with, so I am using MySQL native password plugin. MySQL native password 2 by enter the password for user. code Sagar at 123. So we have created a new user. So let's fetch the list of users. As you can see, we have created one new user and we have changed the host for Code Sagar also. So if you are planning to use this database with PHP or PHP MyAdmin, then you have to use a native password plugin because there are some known issues with some of PHP versions that can create problem when you connect from remote. So it's better to use MySQL native password plugin. Flush privileges to clear the memory. And exit from the MySQL prompt. So we are done with the two steps. Lastly, you will also need to open the port 3306, MySQL's default port, to allow traffic to MySQL. So I am using AWS EC2 instance, so I can open this port from AWS console. Let's go to AWS console. So this is my EC2 instance. Click on the instance. Then you can find security tab. Click on the security group. And in the inbound section, you can edit the inbound rules. So add rule, search MySQL. So you can choose anywhere and save the rules. So this will open the 3306 port on my EC2 instance. So everything is done. So let's try to connect from the machine. So let's try to connect. And the connection is successful. Thanks for watching my video.